Hello, everybody. This is Max Farrow. Today is the 21st of February, 2019, and this is Trading with Max. Okay, so earlier I was recording a webinar, and on the webinar we did a TNT strategy scan of the market and got into a trade. Now this video is a little bit longer, so we're going to go through the motions, but I want you to really listen to the way that I break the market down and the way I look at it and how I decipher whether I'm going to trade on Nadex or if I'm going to trade on Forex. There's a lot of good details in here, all right? So this is a little bit longer video, but at the end of the video, I'll have a nice little deal for you. If you're brand new to the site or the systems, there'll be a great little deal for you. Appreciate your time. Enjoy the video. Now, this is the very first part here with. Now, if we would have been here, you know, what's that, about an hour ago, that would have been a good trade to be in. We would have set ourselves back out pretty good, but I didn't get into that one an hour ago. I was in building, systems this morning. So let's get on to Audi JPY. And if you're new to the TNT system, the first T stands for spotting the trend. So we use the 50 MA to spot the trend. And with our arrow system, there's three indicators that are on here: support and resistance, the moving average, and the MDM arrow system. And what this portrays is that the market in a particular time period moving in a particular direction. And we help you follow that direction and understanding that markets will always follow a trend and have pullback, or what we refer to as negation. So you spot the trend, you wait for negation, and then you wait for continuance, which would be the trade. That's when you would do the trade. So if we had a nice little downtrend happening here, the first arrow after negation, which would have been this arrow, would have been a trade. In this particular one, not so much, because I'm looking to see if structure has been broken. And how do we spot structure? We look left. So back in about an hour for this one, I should probably turn off my Skype line while we're in this. Audi JPY, put a note in for coming back. Now, when market gets really influx and starts messing around like this, I don't even bother with it. We're looking for a clear, decisive trend. I'm not looking to make any trade happen right now or use any other system other than the TNT at the moment. I get stuck into flag patterns and all that stuff, and it's something that you can get in with double bottoms, double tops, all that stuff. But this takes time to learn how to read the market and see it almost immediately of what it's doing and when to avoid. And even though that this is sort of an up pattern, it sort of breaks structure right here. It breaks this structure right here by heading back down and crossing the MA over. You could still be within structure following the MA, and if you do get a little crossover, it's almost going back to the mean, bouncing off the line, almost treating it like a support zone area. But in this particular case, I wouldn't get into this trade. First off, you're getting a big movement. Second off, it's breaking structure already within itself. Let's look at the Great Britain Pound JPY. Again, nothing there that's substantial to show me a good trend. Great Britain Pound USD, same thing. USD CAD. Now, this is the establishment of a reversal of trend coming in, coming back down, and then going back up again. Of course, I'm like Captain Obvious right now. But the idea of this thing establishing itself later on, I mean, if you got in here, and it established, you're looking for two or three really good arrows to come on board, or a couple of arrows to come on board to establish the trend before. Like if you get negation here, if I were to get a down arrow up here, I wouldn't follow that as a signal. The down arrow has to be following structure. Hopefully we'll be able to see one of those. This is kind of sort of where we would look at this, but again, we're not really establishing a good trend. The start of trend's happening right about here. So this would possibly be an arrow to get into, but this is a lot of volatility to come in. I'm looking for nice, clear, and I'll show you on what it looks like on the 15-minute to be on. Remind me to come back to this one, Thor, USDCHF. I just want to see what the other part of the market looks like. on the 1 on the 2 hour side. But if we can't find something specifically, those zones will be set by the time we come back. All right, so that was the 1 hour. On the 1 hours, we would use Nadex's intraday. And because it's a 5 minute chart, the indifferences between structure and where we're getting in is usually about maybe 5, 6, 10 pips, right? So our R values are gonna be 10 pips to 10 pips. Whereas in the 2 hour or the 15 minute chart, we'll probably be hitting 20 or 30 pips in that area. All right, Audi USD. Committed to structure, committed to downtrend, and boom, right there. So first one right out of the gate, looks like we're getting into a trade. I'm gonna pop over to my system over here. Is this it? Nope. Yep, this is it right here. All right, so we're gonna be looking at, this is where we would've gotten in 70.90. We're coming back up to just outside of structure at 71.17. So that would be Audi USD. I'm going to do a new order. We're going to get in for the sell. We're only in for 2 micro pips. We're coming back up here. Wait, we got to get on the 15 minute chart. Back up to here. We're using about 36 pips right in that area. Now remember, this is a 15 minute trade or 15 minute chart. So it's got more of a process to it. I mean, there's more risk to it, but then there's also more reward. We're gonna do about a 1-to-1 risk reward there. I'm gonna pan back to look at where a left structure is. And if you can kind of see on my chart here, it's just below this area of previous lows. I see that it's pretty powerful. Even if I come back to a 1 hour chart, we can kind of see that these marks have been hit a few times. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move this up because I want this take profit to be hit. Okay, so if I'm gonna leave it, I'm gonna leave it. I can also sit and watch this. Now you can make this adjustment for yourself. It kind of messes with the R value just a little bit, 25 to 36. So you could move your risk down, but I want to stay outside of structure on this one. Okay, so there we go. We'll be getting a profit here pretty soon after we hit the spread. Now, how do we use this same information for the Nadex side? Give me 1 second. Simply, we could do it on a binary. We're going to go to the Audi USD. We're going to go to a 2 hour trade, or so that'd be 1 o'clock. And I have too many windows open. I apologize. 71.14 in that area. Oops, sorry. I beg your pardon. Again, I deal with so many things. That's my
your son.
No, that's my karate dojo, but not that I'm plugging that. What was it? Oh yeah, Nadex 7114. Yeah, so it's pretty much far out. So let's go look at structure to see if we can decipher. I don't normally like to use the bottom part of like the lower lows going. 70.98, so you know, 7100 would probably be pretty good to be able to use. But this is, again, market's moving pretty fast at this point. So we're sitting down at 70.82 at the moment. If you're trading, because I got into that trading forex, doing all that stuff. If you have a few favorite pairs, if you like those pairs, stay with those pairs. You know, this is a 19. I can come back in and do that, but I would really want to be up here. You know, we're talking about 2 hours from now. We don't know what we don't know. So if I'm going to do it, I would do a working order on this process. I wouldn't choke this thing down to get close because we're not talking about a huge amount of movement and it only takes a little bit for it to go against it for that solution. Using TNT is more favorable for using either on spreads or using on Forex at this time. I do use it on Nadex, of course. But if I'm only going to focus on that, then I got to make sure that I'm in at exactly 11 o'clock, or I'm on the top of the hour, or I'm on the odd hour, and I'm really focused on getting that pair, and just screaming down the charts and looking at every single one. Does that make sense? So it's not that I'm trying to get to a point of discussing it and sitting back and drinking coffee and that. I really need to be fast and furious to get on. Paul, you have a question?
Yeah, I was going to suggest, would you ever, on the trade you're doing, go to the 12 p.m. expiry so that you have an hour rather than the 2 hour?
Off of the 2 hour chart? Yeah, I mean, volatility sometimes is a quick motion back up, just like a quick dart, and it may not leave you enough time for expansion return. So you might have like a quick push up and then it goes back down, where this is the 1 hour expiry, you might lose. And when the 2 hour expiry, you might win, right? If this was your statement price. So you might have like a quick jog up in that process. The 2 hour gives you enough time on a 15 minute chart. If not, shoot down to the 1 hour chart or the 5 minute chart on the 1 hour trade system, and collect yourself that way to see if there's a setup. Don't use those setups for short term, because that's a completely different variable again. The system's been tested out on a 15 minute chart for a 2 hour trade that has a very high rate of success. Does that make sense?
No, that's great. It's just that I wondered if anybody else had wondered why you didn't go for the 1 hour instead of the two. That makes perfect sense to me.
Yeah, so the solution, what Paul was referring to, is like, would we have taken this on a 1 hour trade? And the answer, yeah, you could have, but that comes with a different success rate. And that's up to you to figure out at that point. There are too many variables for me to figure out anymore. You know, I mean, come on, we got dailies, we got intradays, we got ATMs, we got OTMs. Jesus Christ, how much stuff do we have? We have a tremendous amount. So my biggest suggestion to all of you is to find something that floats your fancy and run it to death. I am now no longer trading 5 minutes. I'm no longer trading daily exchanges out as much as I used to. I will trade ATMs and OTMs when I see fit, when I got a good high rate of success. But I will trade TNTs all day long. I can come in and I know exactly when to show up to my computer. Exactly. On the hour or on the odd hour, every 2 hours. Okay, so the video is done. The trade has been finished. Here is the history of the Audi USD that happened on the 21st. Why is it only 2.2 pips and 40 and 48 cents a profit? Is because after about an hour and a half, 2 hours, if it's sitting on the market, what I do is that I slowly bring down my stop loss and I bring it just over break even and into profit. Maybe it's superstructure or something structured in a candlestick. On, if you watching the videos, you know what I'm referring to. And as I start to grab profit, if the market comes back and hits it, at least I'm not losing any money. So it was a good trade to be in. We made, you know, just a couple cents on it, but 2.8 pips. We survived through that process through our little trailing stop loss solution. So pretty exciting on how all this works out. If you like these videos and watching the trade and the trade scans and trading live with Maxx, please subscribe to the channel, smash the like button, and also hit that little bell for notifications so you get access to these as they come over. It's almost like your little tiny learning center. If not, then you want to join DexFXMarkets.com. Let me give you an opportunity, because I said that I was going to give you a little gift here. If you type in TNT50 into the coupon code, this will knock 50 bucks off for your first month just for watching this video and being here with us today. So I'm Maxx Farrell. This is DexFXMarkets.com, trading live with Maxx, and we'll see you next time. And as always, trade well.